computer. Morning, guys. So, Warrior Wednesday. All you're going to need is a kettlebell. If you haven't got a kettlebell, grab yourself a rucksack, fill it up with books or heavy objects. So you've just got a usable kettlebell to make do. So Pablo, go make shift a kettlebell right now. And you can also use a dumbbell if you've got a dumbbell that'll work as well. And you might want some small dumbbells if you want to for the skater squats. You can do that, although you don't need them. You can just do it on body weight. Okay, so other than that, get yourself some water. Pause the video now if you're watching on replay to go get yourself set up. Everybody else, let's get warmed up. So, we'll just start with a few bits of mobility. Little bits of mobility. So, if you just come down forwards into your quadruped, wrists underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips, curl your toes in, so you've got 6 points of contact. Okay, like so. And all I want you to do here is just come forward and backwards on the wrists. So you're trying to get the shoulders in front of the fingertips and then behind the fingertips. When you do this, I want you to press the shoulder blades forwards, okay? If you can compress your shoulder blades like this, I want you to decompress them by just pressing the shoulder blades forwards like that, okay? So fill the back out and then just slide back and forth, spreading the fingers, so big open hands, flexing out those wrists, and then just go side to side. And then from here, just go round the wrist circles and then round the wrist the other way. Paying lots of attention to our wrist lately. Okay, and then from here, we're just going to go into our cat-cow, so get that spine inflection. Bring your chin towards the ceiling, tail towards the ceiling, and then tuck the tail under into a cat, drop the head, round off that spine, flexing the spine, back into extension. Into that cow. Yeah, this one's a cow. And then cat, just floss back and forwards every 3 seconds. Swap position. Really get a good stretch of that spine. Every 3 seconds, just change it. Drop that head, tuck that tail. Once more, guys. Good, and then come into a lunge position. Left foot to your left hand, okay? From here, take a nice deep breath in and bring your elbow towards the floor as low as you can. As you exhale, good, take another deep breath in, and exhale to the ceiling. Open up that back, chest to the ceiling, deep breath. Exhale down, go a little bit lower, stretch out that groin. Deep breath in. Exhale to the ceiling. Big open stretch to the ceiling. From this position here, place one hand on either side of the foot and just straighten out that front leg. Get a good stretch of that hamstring. Bring the hips back. Drop your head and your chest towards the knee. Point the toe to the ceiling. And then from this position here, bring your knee over your ankle. Okay? Squeeze your right glute, so you feel a nice stretch in this hip flexor. Torso nice and tall over the hips. Hands over your head, reach up to the ceiling. Squeeze that right glute. Nice deep relaxing breaths. And then from here, just press that knee forwards in front of the toe. So put a bit of weight on the thigh and just press the knee to go in front of the toe, but while keeping the ankle on the floor. So we're opening up this ankle now. So getting that flexion in the ankle joint, trying to get that knee in front of the toe, or as far as you can stretch it to, without the ankle lifting up. This is going to allow you to squat deeper, give you more range of mobility in the range of movement in the squat. We're going to do some skater squats today. Single leg work. Okay, and push back. We'll just swap over now. So bring your right foot to your right hand, right tight side. Deep breath in. Exhale. Bring that elbow towards the ground as low as you can. Deep breath in again. Exhale to the ceiling. Deep breath in. Exhale to the floor. Once more, deep breath in. Exhale. Open up to the ceiling. Ooh. Stretching out that hip. Okay, push the hips back. Straighten out that front leg, one hand on either side. Get a nice stretch of that hamstring. Toes to the ceiling, drop your head and your chest towards the knee. Stretch out that hamstring. Every time you exhale, just sink and relax, melt into the stretch. Okay, into your hip flexor, so knee over the ankle. Okay, into this lunge position, squeeze your left bum cheek now, your right leg should be in front. Reach the hands overhead, stretch out that hip. And then from here, we're just gonna press that knee in front of the toe, open up that ankle. If you've got tight ankles, it'll limit your depth in your squat. Just bring in that knee in front of the toe as much as you can, but keep that heel on the floor. Press down on the top of the thigh just to give it a little bit of pressure, just to ease more into that stretch. Your right would tend to be tighter just because of pushing down the gas pedal, although we haven't really been doing much of that lately. Saving petrol, saving money on petrol, right? Good, and then from here, just come into a squat stance. Hook your fingers underneath your toes like this, your bum's in the air, and just spend a moment relaxing in this forward fold. So you stretch out the hamstrings, you squeeze your quads to straighten out the legs, you feel more into those hamstrings. Okay, take a deep breath in, and exhale, and just squat down, torso nice and tall, elbows inside the knees, get your back and chest nice and tall, spine nice and long. From this, just release this position here, release your right hand, and then rotate it to the ceiling. Look the chest and the eyes to the ceiling. And do exactly the same on the opposite side. Fingers under the toes. Release your left hand. Rotate that left hand to the ceiling. Oh, pop. Open up that back. Okay, fingers back under the toes. And then just floss back and forward. Stretch the legs. And then come back down to that tall squat. Lift the chest. Stretch the legs. Straighten out the quads. Straighten out the legs, come back down, hinge into that squat, lift the chest nice and tall, open up those hips. Just do three more, chest up nice and tall. Nice two, straighten the legs, stretch the hamstrings, drop the head, chest nice and tall in the squat. One more, down. And that should have got us a lot looser. Right, just a few ramp ups now. We're going to go into some jacks. So 15 seconds of jacks, 5 seconds, little breather, and then we're going to go 15 seconds drop squats. Okay, we're just going to do 2 seconds off, so two rounds off. Nothing intense, don't kill yourself here. We're just trying to get that heart rate, get the blood pumping, get the lungs start to get them blowing, but don't gas yourself here. It's not what we're after, we're just still warming up. Okay, so feet out nice and wide. Hands above your head, 15 seconds. Nice and light on the toes. Clap at the top, bounce the feet, and clap at the bottom. Okay? And then from there, we're gonna go 5 seconds rest, and then need to drop squats. Feet come together. We're gonna drop the feet out, point the toes to 11 and 1 o'clock, push the knees out, drop, tag the floor, back in again. Keep that torso nice and tall as we do so, okay? So feet out, hands above your head, 15 seconds, let's go. Nice and light on the toes. Clap overhead every time the feet go out. Clap the thighs every time they come in. And relax. 5 seconds rest into those drop squats. 3, 2, feet together. 1, go. Tag the floor. Pop the feet out. Turn the toes towards 11 and 1 o'clock. And the knees are going to track the toes in the same direction. And breathe. 5 seconds rest. Once more. Back onto those jacks. In 3, 2, 1, let's go, last set. Clap at the top, clap at the bottom. Nice and light on those toes. And relax for 5. One more set of those drop squats. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Little hop in and out. Keep the torso tall so don't bend over. Torso nice and tall. And relax easy. Get some water, guys. Grab yourself your kettlebell. I'll walk you through today's exercises. Mm-hmm. Okay, so last couple of weeks we've been working on your skater squats. Wonderful exercise for healthy knees. So when we do these, we're challenging your lower body strength. Okay, so we're gonna go left leg first, and you're gonna rep out on your left leg. Your goal is to bring your torso forwards, reach forwards with your hands to keep your balance. So your torso reaching forwards and your hands out is your counterbalance. This back leg, you're gonna keep the heel curled in, okay, and out of the equation. I'll give you a couple of variations, okay? The variation that I want you to do, and then a progression if you need to make it a little bit easier. So reach forwards, we get 3, 2, slowly down, tap the knee on the pad, and push out of it. So just use a pillow on the floor, and that's the target. Don't rest on the pillow. Okay, so when you tap it, when you feel it, that's your cue to push back up again. Don't worry if the pillow decompresses 2-3 centimeters, sink into it, but what we don't want to do is rest, okay? So what I want you to do, left leg down, reach the torso forwards, slow, touch the pad, push out of it, okay? That's your skater squat. Now, if that's too hard, take the pillow away, okay? Do exactly that, but use your resting leg to assist on the way back up, okay? Okay, so slow, keep going, rest the leg and push out of it with the back leg. So that's an easier version, okay? So we go slow. We do exactly the same, but with the back leg, we can use it to push out of it from the bottom. The bottom and returning to the top is the hardest bit, okay? So use your back leg if you need to, that's fine. So what we're gonna do is 60 seconds on the left leg, 15 seconds rest, shake it out, and then we do 60 seconds on the right leg, okay? Easy peasy. Then what we're gonna do, your third exercise is, there's a combination of things here, is a kettlebell clean and then a curtsy lunge. Let me show you both exercises and then we'll put them together. So the kettlebell clean, we start with a kettlebell at our groin. In fact, you're gonna be completing a deadlift every time. So from this position here, you complete the deadlift and you're gonna pull and roll the kettlebell up off the floor like this, okay? So that the elbow's tucked in, the thumb is in line with your breastbone, and the kettlebell's sitting on your outside of the forearm, okay? So not inside, not around, not on your shoulder, sitting on your forearm, your wrist, your forearm, elbows tucked in. So that's from your kettlebell clean. So from the floor, we do a deadlift, we roll the kettlebell up. Let me show you a little trick, okay? Thumb facing towards your bum, okay? If your thumb's facing towards your bum, as you stand and roll the wrist, it gives the kettlebell some spin. So it just rolls up your body. Keep the kettlebell as close to your body as you can. Don't swing it out in front. So don't do this, okay? So from this position here, roll the kettlebell up, okay? So turn the thumb away towards your bum or towards the opposing knee, that's fine, just to give you that roll, okay? So that's your kettlebell clean. Let's have a little practice of that first, guys. So just check in on you and show me your kettlebell clean. So deadlift, single arm deadlift to kettlebell clean. Let's go, Ali. Single leg, single arm dead. Oh, no. So Ali, I want you to do complete a deadlift every time. So from the floor, Pablo, you're doing something else. Okay. Yeah, just a little bit more aggression with the deadlift, Ali. Let's go. Show me, Marie. Yeah, just to the shoulder, Pablo. Just to the shoulder. Yep, just to the shoulder. Okay. Good, Marie. Yep, Nat. So, yeah, that's it. Good. Okay, Penny, just show me. So, just good. Okay, yeah, but don't throw it too high. Don't throw it too high. I just want it to gently land on the forearm into the shoulder. Okay, so don't overthrow it over the shoulder. Abby, you just show me for me, mate. I can see your bollocks. I can't see your kettlebell. Okay, right. So, that's the clean, okay? So Penny, don't overthrow it. Okay, just from here, roll it. So nice and aggressive with that deadlift, Ali, and roll it up your body. That's your kettlebell clean. That's how you're gonna transition from left to right. We're gonna complete the deadlift and clean the kettlebell up every time, okay? Right, then your curtsy lunge. So play, let's say the kettlebell's in our right hand, okay? Kettlebell's in our right hand. We're gonna keep the right leg in front. So if the kettlebell's in the right hand, we're gonna go right leg. We're gonna work the right leg. We take the left leg back, cross it over that right leg, and we come into a lunge, okay? Curtsy. So you're doing a little curtsy, but with a lunge. Do you understand? So the kettlebell will be in the right hand, take the leg back, practice with me, guys. Cross it behind that center line, and then drop the back knee to the floor so you really hit these glutes, the glute medius, side of your hips, okay? And then what we do is we drop the kettlebell down, complete a deadlift, swap the hand, and then complete on the opposite side, okay? So it looks like this. Ready? Eyes and ears. Okay. A little bit slower. From there. Deadlift in tight. Curtsy out. Curtsy out. Okay. So have a little practice of that, guys. So clean the kettlebell, then a curtsy lunge. Good. Take it nice and slow. Yep, no press. Don't press overhead. Just keep the kettlebell on your shoulder. Deadlift the kettlebell each time. Good. Nice and slow. Good work, guys. That's it, Marie. So cross that leg over and relax. Good. Okay. So that's exercise number three. So we've done skaters left, skaters right. Then we've done your kettlebell clean to curtsy lunge. Okay? Then we're going to do a bent over row. So chop and drop at the hips. So we're in this bent over position. Chest just above parallel. So you've got full extension of the arms. You're going to pull the kettlebell in towards your chest, swap the hand and catch it. Catch it. Catch. 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 So we've got a nice little arm burner, depending on how heavy your kettlebell is. At the same time, we're doing that single arm row. And we're giving it some extra weight by releasing the weight. As we throw it up, we let it go. And we've got to catch it. In that moment of catching it, you're just adding a little bit extra weight onto the kettlebell. Okay, key things there is the back's nice and flat. Don't round the spine. Push the bum out, lift the chest out, row and catch, okay? Nice and simple. From here, your last exercise number four, your fifth and final exercise, we're gonna hold the boat pose. So we did this yesterday, right? Keep the knees bent. Okay, so that's your boat pose. You're gonna take your kettlebell, hold it into your forearm, make a fist with the opposite hand. From here, push overhead, control it on the way back down. Okay, you're gonna swap every three reps. So once you've done three on your left side, spin it over, complete three on your right side, okay? So key things there, and you will shift, you will wobble, you might even touch the floor every now and again, that's fine. It's just get good at keeping the feet off the floor, keeping your back off the floor, abs engaged, make a fist with the opposite arm, okay? So that's your boat press, all right? Every three reps, we're gonna swap over each side, okay? Right, guys, have a last sip of water. Your first set, we're gonna go for 60 seconds. That is 60 seconds of work, 15 seconds transition. I'll walk you through each exercise so you know what you're doing. God, I don't know why the heating was up. Roosting. Okay, guys, starting with those skater squats. If you got your sound on, just flip yourself off, please. Just so we don't get any feedback. Okay, guys, skate squats. 60 seconds in 3, 2, let's go. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Count 4 seconds on the way down. Left leg, only left leg. 3, 2, 1. Come out of it. Reach forwards. 4, 3, 2, 1. Chop. 4, 3, 2, 1. Chop. 4, 3, 2, 1. Push up all on that left leg. 4, 3, 2, 1. Shut. 4, 3, 2, 1. If you're struggling, use your back leg to stand up. One leg on the way down, keep that leg curled in. And then on the way up, push up off your back leg. That's fine. 4 seconds on the way down. Tilt forwards. Let's go. Pause it to the way back. Reach forwards. Push out. Four. Three. Two. Push. Four. One. Your right leg should be your strong leg. You use this leg. You do this exercise every time you get in and out of the car. It's really good for your knees. Use those glutes. Slow, slow, slow. Ten seconds. Okay, rest. Get your kettlebell. 15 seconds. Clean and curtsy. And then catch. Squat. Ready? Go. Time. some water. Here's some water. Yeah. Okay. Beautiful job, guys. Right. Sip some water. Any questions? If you need any modifications, just unmute yourself and talk to me. Some key points. I did this in the flow of it. I didn't tell you this when I was demonstrating the first exercise, but you probably picked it up from when I was doing it, if you were watching the screen. On the clean to curtsy, man, 60 seconds of that is killer. Legs are on fire. And you're like, you saw me taking little breaks, rest to give your best. Push until you can't, rest until you can. Okay, shake the lactic acid there, pick up where you left off. Right, so a little tip with the clean and curtsy, okay? Once you've cleaned it, you've done your curtsy, as you're coming back in, release it just by giving it a nudge, swap hands so it drops down into the opposite, so you completely deadlift and you're good to go. So as you nudge it off the shoulder, okay, catch it, swap it about here, then the opposite hand, and then deadlift with the other to roll it up onto the other side, okay? In the warm-up, when I was demoing it, I was slowing it down, and I was bringing it to the floor every time and was swapping on the ground. Don't do that. If you feel confident to do so, roll it off the shoulder, catch, switch. You get more flow from it. So it looks like this. From here, make a fist with the other hand, not on your thigh. Up, roll, drop into that curtsy. Okay, from here, swap, down, roll. Yeah, swap, down, roll. So you get more flow of it. So just swap around about here. Okay? But just go slow. Okay, don't rush through it. Otherwise you might chip the floor. And we don't do that. Right, guys, round two, 45 seconds this time. So this one's an easier round. This one's an easier round, but that doesn't mean you go easier. First set was a good practice set, okay? To hustle, but to pay some homage to the exercise and get it right. This second set, can we spice it up a little bit? So now we know what we're doing, we make it look good. We put more into it. Because we know we haven't got to slug out for 60 seconds, only 45 this time. So don't hold anything back. Keep everything as tight as you can. Yeah, that boat press hard. Your feet probably wobbling all over the place. Your attention should be on your tummy to keep as tight and everything engaged as possible as you're pressing. Right, back into your skaters. Remember on the skaters, I'm looking for 4 seconds on the way down. 4 seconds on the way down. So 45 seconds work, 15 seconds rest. Ready? Skaters. 13. Beautiful work, let's go. Slow. Push out it. 4 seconds on the way down. Reach the hands forward. Go slow. Try not to rest in the knee on the floor. Sink into the cushion. Okay, sink into your cushion. Just don't rest on the floor. 20 seconds, guys. One more. Oh. Ah, rest. Okay, clean and curtsy. Ready?
Ready?
Yep. Seconds rest. Just because we're doing less time doesn't mean it gets easier. As we start the fatigue, it means we keep the quality high. Okay, this is your last push, your last finish. You don't need your legs, don't need your arms for the rest of the workout. So get this done. No swing back home, we get straight across to the other side. So don't leave anything in the reserve. Okay, 30 seconds. Get your reps, finish your reps. Those curtsy squats are absolute fire. Absolute fire. Really get that leg over, just lights up your ass cheeks. Especially combined with that single arm deadlift, the glutes are just getting battered. Woo! It's good though, team, it's good. Make your lightweight, heavyweight. Right, let's do this. Last set, best set. Remember, real slow on those skaters. That's how we do it. And if you're using a pillow, don't just touch it and then come up. Because your pillow's got a bit of give, more give than this foam, sink into the pillow, so we get good depth. Do you know what I mean? Because your pillow ain't going to give you anything to get back up off. The floor will. So you can just sink a little bit into the pillow and keep the weight on that front leg and then drive out a bit. So you get more depth. Yeah? Okay. Woo. Let's go, guys. 30 seconds this time, 15 seconds rest. One more time for it. Let's go. Slow. Good nap. Good Suki. Good Pablo. That's it. Sink into it. Use that one leg. Good Pen. Beautiful. Okay, let's go right leg. Shift legs up. 10 seconds. Not yet. You ready? Right leg.
Ready?
Strong leg. Let's go. Slow. And go.
We could
slow.
Be loving.
And go.
Why would you be saving?
The slower the better.
Very late.
The slower the better. Good nap. That's it, Pablo. Abby, real slow. Good, Ali. Pablo, where'd you go? Okay, guys, let's go. Curtsy. Curtsy. Ready? Clean, curtsy, catch. Clean, curtsy, catch. Yeah, Rose. Ready? Drop, drop. Make the fist with the other arm. Back to back. Let's go. Oh, don't stop. Get those reps, guys. Good, Ali. Good, Ali. Good. Make a fist with the other hand, Ali. Marie, take your other hand out to the side. That's how it's done, Abby. Good, Nat. Take the free hand to the side. Pass it over. Nice, Penny. Penny, pull it more into your chest. So pull it right up to your chest. Pablo, come back to us. Let's go, guys. Last set, don't press. Really inside. Ready?
Ready?
Oh, 10 seconds, guys. Good, Marie. Good nap. One big finish, guys. Time. And rest easy. Woo. Good job. Good hustle.
Hello.
Hey, guys.
Hi there.
Excuse me. Talk to me. How did you find that? Pablo, just mute yourself.
Those curtsy things are really hard.
They're hard. Yeah. Good.
They're really hard. If I overthink them, I can't do them.
It's because you've done, there's two sets of skater squats. Follow that up with the curtsies. That is absolutely savage.
Ugh.
Absolutely savage. Did you feel your arse light on fire?
My arse is on fire.
Good. You're doing them proper then. You're doing them proper. Well done, guys.
Definitely. Is Ali okay? Is Ali okay?
Ali, you all right?
Okay.
Good stuff. Good stuff, guys. Well done. Right, nice little finisher then for your abs. Okay, you're going to do 20 seconds on, 5 seconds. So 20 seconds on, 10 seconds rest. 20 seconds on, 10 seconds rest. Two ab exercises, which we're going to alternate. We do one, then the other. One, then the other. For a total of 8 rounds, so 4 minutes. So, your knee grabs, which you're good at.
Oh.
You're nice and quiet for a moment, guys, because I haven't...
I hate it, that's busy.
Just nice and quiet for a moment, please, guys. Okay, so from the floor, knuckles under your chin, legs straight, throw your arms forwards, bring the knees to your bum, plug your knees, lay back down, nice and slow on the way down. Up, explosive, slow on the way down. Knuckles stay under your chin or on your chest here, it's fine. If you're struggling, you can take them overhead, so that's now going to assist because you can swing from overhead. And if you're still struggling, use your arms to get up. So you push your elbows into the floor to get up, hook your knees, slow on the way down without your arms, okay? So that's your knee grabs, your knee hooks, okay? Right, 20 seconds, 10 seconds rest. Then we go into your hollow hold, okay? Start with your legs up to the ceiling, okay? Hands overhead, bring the shoulders off the floor, and then your challenge is to lower the feet, reach your arms out, but keep the shoulders off the floor, keep the feet off the floor. And remember that posterior tilt that we were working on last week? And most people have, or many people have the hips like this. Okay, we should be like this. But we're going to tuck the hips under like this. We're going to try and hold that posterior tilt by doing that, okay? Beautiful, guys. So 20 seconds on, 10 seconds rest. We're going to alternate between those two ab exercises. We'll fry those abs. Like, true to my word, no arms, no legs. I just need you to give it me with your abs now, okay? Ready, guys? Let's go. 20 seconds of knee grabs. Ready, team? Together. Go.
I had my head in train sound. They told me that.
Come on, guys, give it some. This is your finish. Finish strong. Rest. Rest. We're going to go into a hollow hold. 5. Legs up. Shoulders up 4. And reach out. Hold. Woo! Took that tail under. Hold. Rest. Back up to your knee hooks. Ready? Let's go.
And it's only cause I heard you say, and it's only cause I walked your way. I heard you say,
come on, guys. Rest. Don't stop now. Don't stop now. Rest. Suck it in. Back into your hollow hold. Ready? Knee grabs. Round 3. Ready? Ready? Let's go. Come on, guys, finish. Big finish. Rest. Rest. Ready? Ready? Keep them up, guys. Shoulders up the floor. Last set. Last set. Come on, together. Big finish. Let's go. Try and get 10 or more. Okay, last hollow hole. Come on, all together, guys. Last hollow hole. Keep them feet off the floor. Shoulders up the floor. Let's go. Discipline. Stay focused. 10 seconds, guys. We've got this. Hello, Dubs. Who can honestly say their feet didn't touch the floor?
No, my feet touched the floor. Help it.
Hands up, your feet did not touch the floor throughout the hollow holds.
Well done, Nat.
Well done, guys.
Well done, Nat. Absolutely savage.
That was hard.
Very hard. Well done. That's arms, that's legs, and now abs, nailed, cardio, heart, lungs. We got them. Superb work today, guys. Warriors. Some high fives. Well then, team.
The only part of my body that doesn't hurt is my eyelids.
Eyelids. And we got hardcore tomorrow, so I've just give you a little taste of what's to come tomorrow's core workout.
Oh God.
Really, really good session.
Oh God. I think I was sick out my nose at one point. You're up, Pab.